bamboo skirt, two-tone. Yeah, we're getting there gradually. For first-timers, please subscribe and remember to hit the notification bell so you get notified the moment we drop a new video. I remain Oluwa Folakemi, your tutor on this channel. What are we getting into today? And what are we using? There it is listed right there. Let's get right into it. Using the pattern we created in part one. If you remember, we used it in part two to do the one tone. Now we need it for two tone. But before we go on, we have to tape it back together. The point where we cut it for part one, we tape it back together because that point will not be usable for this particular project. Well, the cutting will be such that it has to be hidden. I decided to tape it at the back to reinforce that point. You might decide not to tape it at the back, but for me, I just feel okay, let me do that. Then I cancel the addition sign I put there. I indicated plus sign at the point where I'll be cutting now. So I know to add seam allowances there when I place it on my fabric. That's done. I open up the pattern. One will be going for the plain while the other will be going for the print. I open up the pattern, place it on the fabric, and I tape it in place. You can decide to pin it straight up, but for me, I feel it's easy to just tape it on the head first, add my seam allowances, cut off the excess, then pin it together. Whichever one is preferable for you is fine. Just know that you have to have fun with it. Don't stress yourself too much. Don't stress yourself, in fact. Not just stressing yourself too much. Don't stress yourself. Have fun with it. So, adding our one centimeter seam allowance around the point where we're supposed to add them. Remember, we added the we indicated the sides that would require seam allowances in part two. I'm following those markings. And peradventure you prefer to use more than 1 centimeter allowance, feel free to do whatever it is would be fine for you. Allowances added, now I cut. Endeavor you duplicate every available cut. Cutting done. Now let's pin it together. I mean the pattern and the fabric. Pattern paper and the fabric. Because we need to transfer the fold to the fabric by way of steam pressing. And peradventure you don't have a steam presser because a live student asked me, a student asked me in one of our live classes, she doesn't have a steam presser, what can she use? A steam iron would do really well, would do good. If it's a steam iron you have around, fair enough, if you have the regular iron, it will also work, but a steam iron would do better. So, that's done. I fold it and tape it in place so we can take it to our presser and transfer the folds to the fabric. So I'll take the liberty to do the other one behind the seam. The process is the same. You add your seam allowance, place it on the fabric, add your seam allowance, cut off the excess, pin it together, fold, take it to your steam press, then we'll be back. Yeah, we're back. All pressed and ready to be detached from the pattern paper. So detach the pins. So you can separate the pattern paper from the fabric. We'll be using the same pattern for the three tone. So I just flip the tape onto the pattern so I don't have to mess up the pattern paper, because I'll still be using it one more time. I do the same for the other side. And peradventure you intend to use it for more than one project, I would advise you do it in a thicker fabric and a thicker pattern and thicker paper, a cardboard of some sort. Those ones can really go through the rigor of going back and forth and still be able to hold together. But if you just need it for one project, a regular 80 gram paper would be fine. So there it is. Now let's join them together at the point where we ripped, where we cut the pattern into two. Remember I said that point has to be as even as possible. As such, it's within one of the folds. It has to be within the folds. Marking out my seam allowance, then take it to my sewing machine and stitch it in place. Stitch done. I trim off the excess there. Take out my pins. Now let's commence the folding. Please ensure you follow the folds as it was replicated by your steam press or your iron, whatever it is you used. Whatever folds you get, please follow them. So I mark my 1 centimeter from the fold there, roll my seam allowance and stitch it together, then trim off the excess. That's done, and pin it in place. Fraying off the fabric, the print, I may decide not to pin it because it can hold by itself. But the other fabric, the satin, will not hold. That's why I'm so about pins here. On a good day, I might not have used too much pins to hold it in place. So if you are using a fabric that can hold, you can decide to skip pinning it in place once you're done with the trimming off and about to go to the next fold. The only lessons of trimming off the excess, we don't want excess bulk on the fabric, on the completed project. That's what I'm trimming off. As such, if the type of fabric you'll be using will not be too bulky and you feel is fine by you, you can decide not to trim anything off. So going to the next, the process is the same till you get to the very last opening. Done. The process is the same, like I said, till we get to the very last one. We'll soon hasten it up so we don't waste too much time. Hold it in place. Let's see what the final will look like before we get there. that. So let me go to the background and finish it off. I'll be back shortly. Yeah, everything song. That's a bad view. I decided to face it off because I'm not intending to use to face it and to line it all the way. So I just want to face it at the waist and at the end. As such, I'll be using bias to clean off the facing I used. The bias was made out of print, African print. I have a picture tutorial I did about it a little while ago, but I intend to do a video tutorial about it short in a little while. So I pin those in place so we can stitch it and top stitch. Same for the back panel. So, stitching done. You can see the point of the two fabric knitting is now even. Now I want to trim off the excess I don't need there, because really I don't need too much fabric there. Trim that off. Now we'll go and tip the edges with our bias. All done. That's the back panel and that's the front. Now let's stick the two together, pinning them together. Stitch it, and there it is, all completed. Let me show you the inside of the skirt. That's the back view, how the inside looks like. That's the front, that's the back, all looking pretty. Now flip it right side out. There it is, all completed and looking pretty. I would love you to try it. So you can send it to me on Facebook. I'll drop the link to my group there so you can be able to send it. I hope this is very, very helpful to you. So we have the first one tone checked, two tone checked, three tone will be dropping in a few days. Thank you for your time. Please remember to share. Till our next video. Bye-bye for now.